video, I'm going to share with you 20-something instant ways to easily look prettier every day and look like a better version of yourself. So let's get started. And by the way, if you find yourself enjoying this video, will you please give it a thumbs up? It helps me with all the YouTube algorithm stuff. And consider subscribing to my channel, and let's go. One simple way to easily look prettier, and you may already know about this one, is just to simply wear a bold lip color. It could be red or it could be a dark pink. It depends on your personal preference, but it's a super easy way to just elevate your look a little bit. However, one that you may not have heard of and is probably better for right now since we're wearing masks a lot, and if you wore lipstick when you've worn a mask, you know it gets all over the place and it's kind of gross. So what I like to do right now and what I'm doing currently right this second is I like to wear a lip stain. So the color of the lip stain depends on your personal preference, but you wear lip stain, it stays on a lot better, and then you can just put chapstick or lip gloss over it to kind of make it look a little bit more glossy, and it's just a very easy way to have a lip color that stays on even when you're wearing a mask and make you look a little bit prettier. So this next one is a little odd, and it probably was not what you were expecting from this video, but sunglasses can actually make you look prettier. So whenever you have sunglasses on, and of course it has to be outdoors, if you're wearing them inside, you just look like you're being ridiculous. They give you this mysterious je ne sais quoi look, which is pretty attractive. And going back to our previous tips, wearing it with a bold lip is just the icing on the cake. So here's the key with sunglasses. You have to find a pair that fit your face and are a little bit interesting. They don't have to be necessarily the trend or trendy, although I will link my favorite pair below, but they need to be a little bit more interesting than your basic traditional pair of sunglasses. By the way, this is literally the worst day to film a video because there's no sun, it's completely overcast and raining, and my lights are not the best. I apologize. But the color red is seen to be as more attractive. If you put the same person side by side in photos, and one photo you're wearing red and one photo you're wearing blue or something, everyone will look at the red photo and say that one looks prettier because of the color. It does something to our brains. So when in doubt and you want to stand out, I just sounded like Dr. Seuss, you should wear red. One thing that I think a lot of people overlook, and there are a lot of people who put a lot of effort into this, but I'm talking to the people who are overlooking this, are your eyebrows. Seems like just such a simple part of your face, but it can really change your entire appearance. I'm not gonna tell you which way is best to do your eyebrows. That would depend on your preference and your face. I always suggest going to someone who knows what they're talking about when they talk about eyebrows, but also you can simply go to a makeup artist and get them to do your eyebrows, and you will see a different side of your face that you probably didn't see before. If you have really sparse eyebrows and you're trying to get them to grow because you plucked them to death, there is a thing called RevitaBrow. I used that a while back, and oh my goodness, it made my eyebrows just go crazy. I will link it below. It's not cheap, but oh my gosh, it works. One of the things we all do that can make us feel quite not pretty is to look at photos and compare ourselves to photos of IG models that have been filtered and edited and photoshopped to death. Not only that, even if they haven't been filtered and edited and photoshopped to death, that is their best photo. That is the best photo that they had because that's the one they posted. And you're comparing yourself to that. I bet if you found your best photo, you could stand right up next to them. One of the things I've learned from my friend who does my makeup sometimes is to put concealer on your eyeballs, specifically your eyelids. If you just slap some concealer on your eyelids, just use bronzer for your eye makeup, it can create such a clean, beautiful, natural look. My next tip is a little painful, but it's easy. If you're trying to go for minimal makeup, which you should because that is prettier than caking on a bunch of makeup, but if you're trying to go for a more natural look and get your skin to glow and all that good stuff, here's what you need to do. When you wake up in the morning, before you put your makeup on, stick your head in a bowl of ice. It doesn't really necessarily have to be a bowl of ice, but get an ice cube and rub it all over your face. It somehow just wakes your skin up. It probably wakes you up as well. It really gives you a nice setting for this natural glowy look. Down to your lips, if you're trying to make them look a little more stand out and you're trying to use the bold color and the lip stain that I talked about, one thing you can do is instead of using lip liner on the inside of your lips, use it on the actual line of your lips, not on the outside because that's kind of tough and that would be hard to pull off unless you're a professional makeup artist, but on the line of your lips. It'll make your lips just look a little bit more full and a little bit bigger. So as I was listing out the tips for this video, I actually asked my husband and his friend what they consider pretty about a person, and they both said teeth. They said white teeth. And I was really happy they said that because that is kind of an easy one. I don't have a specific whitener to suggest to you. I really haven't found one that I'm like amazed with, and I haven't tried that many out either. But what I have tried, and it actually works, is just using plain old Sensodyne. I drink coffee every single day, maybe a couple times a day. And you know, of course it stains your teeth a little bit, but after using Sensodyne, my teeth have gotten noticeably whiter. Speaking of your teeth, I hate saying this, but if I'm making a video about how to look prettier, I have to say this one, and that is to smile. I know, it's so cheesy, and I hate it when these nasty men are like, smile, honey. It's so gross, but it is true, you do need to smile. Of course, I'm not saying just walk around smiling all the time, but it doesn't hurt to be conscious of times when you could smile versus the times you don't. Now, let me just say real quick, I am a person who has RBF, and if you know what that is, then you may also have that as well. I don't look very friendly when I'm not smiling. I mean, I look straight up unapproachable when I'm not smiling, and I'm really nice. Hopefully you know at this point that you should exfoliate your skin, especially as you get older, in order for it to look better, especially if you're trying to look prettier with less makeup. It's definitely going to be something that's depending on your skin type, your age, and kind of what's going on in your skin. But you should also exfoliate your body. I've noticed as I've gotten older, my skin, especially on my legs, is ashy. And the only thing I have found that actually exfoliates my legs are these gloves that I have mentioned several times on several videos. I'm obsessed with them. They're like $7 for 12 pair or something. But they actually exfoliate my legs and make them look nice and shiny and beautiful. The next thing you should do after you exfoliate your body is to get you a shimmery lotion, not glittery. Don't be getting glitter unless you're going to a rave or something, but shimmery body lotion. I will list a few below, but what it does is just gives your body a nice sheen. Speaking of glowing, self-tanner is also a nice way to make yourself look a little bit more attractive. I don't think you necessarily need that, but if you do like to go that route and you feel like you look better with a tan, a self-tanner is always nice. I don't personally like to use self-tanners, and it's because I always miss spots, always, and I end up having some weird spot on my arm that's not tan. It looks ridiculous. So I'll go to a spray tanning booth if I'm gonna do that, but I wanted to tell you about the easy way to get a tan in a hurry, in under 5 minutes. I found this bronzer. It's like a lotion bronzer. I think it just has coconut oil in it. It's very simple ingredients, but you can smooth it on your skin. I usually do it after I shower, and it immediately gives you a bronzy glow. Another thing to do if you're trying to go for more of a natural, beautiful look without wearing a bunch of makeup is to simply curl your lashes. I don't recommend doing this every day because, you know, you wouldn't want to curl your hair every day, but curling your lashes can always just make your eyes just pop a little bit more naturally. What I do, and I know this is old school and probably not good for them, but I put a hair dryer on my eyelash curler for a few seconds and then I curl them, and it makes my stick straight eyelashes go up a little bit. Another one that I can't really make a video like this without sharing, and that is to stand up straight. I personally have a very big problem with this. I even ordered online on Amazon one of those things you put on your back that's going to buzz whenever I'm slouching. I will let you know how that works. I will link it below. Don't know if it works yet. If you have dark circles, I have a solution for you. I've had dark circles all my life. They're hereditary. I can't get rid of them no matter how much I sleep. If you have dark circles, you need to use an actual color to conceal the dark circles before you put on the concealer. It neutralizes the darkness. So if you have fair skin, you're gonna wanna use a pink color. If you have medium to dark skin, you'll wanna use like a peach or apricot. And I believe for olive skin, it's more of a mustardy green, but it neutralizes the darkness. And then you can put your concealer on and it hides it so much better. Now, if puffiness is your issue, I don't have that issue. I do have dark circles. But what I have heard is that people who have puffy eyes usually put their moisturizer in the refrigerator because the coolness of it just kind of helps depuff their eyes. Moving right along to skin issues that we probably would rather not have. And one of them would be signs of aging that we all get. And if you don't have them yet, you're gonna get them. If you are starting to show small little signs of aging, like wrinkles around your eyes, there is a solution for that. Not to say that wrinkles aren't pretty, because it is a natural sign of aging, so it's not that they're not pretty, but all of us would like to slow it down as much as humanly possible. So I found these patches, and I've been using them for a long time, and basically you put them on your face, they're silicone patches, and they prevent the wrinkles from forming for several hours out of the day. And if you wear them, say, every night when you sleep, sleep, you basically have about 8 hours that wrinkles are unable to form. So I will say that when you wake up in the morning, the wrinkles are gone and they probably stay away till about midday and then they return. They never just go away completely. But if you think about the concept of it, they are preventing wrinkles from forming as fast as they could. And speaking of wrinkles, if you haven't by now, surely you have heard and surely you have a silk pillowcase. It is well known that a silk pillowcase helps decrease the chances of lines forming in your face. It helps your hair not get frizzy and broken and damaged as much. A silk pillowcase is really a must, I feel like, if you're a woman. One of those things that people can't quite identify what makes someone else look prettier or more put together and just a little bit more attractive, but it is a real thing, and that's just wearing simple, dainty jewelry. Costume jewelry and big, loud statement pieces definitely have a place, and we all love them, but if you're just trying to go for this natural, beautiful, pretty look, then dainty jewelry is definitely something you need to invest in. I say invest, but you don't really have to go crazy and spend a bunch of money on it, but if you are getting some dainty jewelry that's something you know you'll wear a lot, you might want to get it in 18 karat gold or some kind of metal that's not going to tarnish, because tarnished jewelry is not pretty. Speaking of what to wear, you should also learn what not to wear or what can ruin what you're wearing with this video. So head to that one next. I hope you liked this video. I had so much fun making it, and I will see you next time.